So second type of problems were coin problems. We have discussed dice problems when single dice is rolled and two dice was rolled. Now we are discussing regarding coins when three fair coins are tossed. As the coins are concerned, you need to remember when single coin, one coin is tossed, that time sample space head comma tail. When two coins were tossed, that time sample space will be HH, HT, TH and TT. Here three fair coins are tossed is given. So we have to write sample space of three coins. To write sample space of three coins, what you need to remember is, you have to check here, two coins are tossed, cases you need to remember. HH, HT, TH, TT. These are the cases for two coins. What we need to do is, just add H to all the values. See, HH is there. I am writing two coin case, I am adding H here. Then HT is there. HT, then H I am writing. Then TH is there. TH and H I am writing. Then TT is there. TT and H I am writing. Then again HH. HH with T. Then HT with T. Then TH with T. Then TT with T. How to remember? Sample space of how many coins? Three coins. To remember sample space of three coins, you have to remember sample space of two coins. HH, HT, TH, TT. Then adding H to all the values till here. Then adding T to all the values of two coins toss case. Now, N of S, how many cases are there total? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Then once we have S and N of S, we have to write event. Here two events are there. First one is, first event equals to, first write sentence whatever given, at least one head. Now take cases in which head is there, at least one head. 2, 3, anything, minimum one head should be there. So how many such cases are there? In this one H is there, in which one H is there, one H, HHNT, HTT, THT, in all cases except the last case we have at least one H. So N of E will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So probability of this event equals to N of E divided by N of S, so that equals to 7 divided by 8. In second bit, event equals to exactly one tail. Write the sentence form. Exactly one tail. If exactly one tail means, you have to check the cases of one tail. Only one tail you have here in from sample space. H, T, H have one tail, T, H, H have one tail, H, H, T has one tail. Exactly one means don't take two things. So N of E will be 3. So probability of such event is N of E divided by N of S. Favorable outcome by total number of outcomes. Okay. Whenever a coin is tossed three times is given, that means three coins are tossed. What is the probability of? A coin is tossed three times, V is nothing but three coins were tossed. So first we'll write sample space of three coins. To write sample space of three coins, you should know sample space of two coins. HH, HT, TH, TT. Now, once we have these cases of two coins, just add H to this one. HH is there, one more H. HT is there, we are writing H. TH is there, we are writing TH, then H. TT is there, we are writing TT and H. Then same thing I am repeating again. HH with T, HT with T, TH with T, TT with T. So N of S will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. First event, E equals to head tail head. Head tail head combination how many times? Head tail head, one head tail head, that is N of E, only one time it is there. So probability of this event is N of E divided by N of S equals to 1 divided by 8. Second one, head, 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 N of E is only one head, head, head is there, first one. So probability of this event again same thing, N of E divided by N of S, 1 divided by 8. Two heads and one tail. In this one, they have not mentioned head, tail, head like that. They have two heads. So anywhere you find two head and one tail, you can take this one. Two head and one tail. H, T, H, we have two head, one tail. Two head, one tail. Two head and one tail. So N of E will be 3. Probability of this event is N of E divided by N of S, 3 by 8. Now we have a coin is tossed 4 times. So when a coin is tossed 4 times, you should remember sample space of 2 coins, HH, HT, TH, TT. When 3 coins were tossed, what we'll do, we'll write, we'll add H to this one. Then we'll add T to this one. These are 3 coin cases. For 4 coin sample space, S equals to, these 3 coin sample space we have to take and we have to add H to all the values first. 3H is there, add 1H. Then HTH is there, HTH, add 1 more H. THH is there, THH, add 1 more H. Then TTH is there, TTH, add 1 more H. Then HHT is there, HHT, 1 more H. HTT, 1 more H. THT, 1 more H. TTT, 1 more H. Then at the end, wherever you have taken H, again you have to write this whole thing by taking last value as T. THH, T, then TTH, T, then HH, TT, then H, TTT, then TH, TT, TTT, and T. N of S will be 16. Event is head all the 4 times. Head all the 4 times. Head all the 4 times, H, 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 how many cases are there, H, 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 only 1 case is there. Probability of event is N of E divided by N of S. So this is 1 divided by 16. Find the probability of getting at least 1 head when 5 coins were tossed. See, we have sample space of 4 coins, right? Once we have sample space of 4 coins, see, this is previous question thing. I'm writing here. 5 coins are tossed, sample space. 5 coins are tossed. So what we have to do here is S equals to, you should know 4 coins tossed case, then you can just take HHH, 1 more H, HH, HTHH, 1 more H, THHH, 1 more H, TTHH, 1 more H, HH, TH, 1 more H, HTTH, 1 more H, TH, TH, 1 more H, TTTH, 1 more H, HTTT, HHT, 1 more H, HTHT, 1 more H. Then we have THHT, 1 more H, TTHT, 1 more H, HHTT, 1 more H, HTTT, 1 more H, THTT, 1 more H, TTTT, 1 more H. Well, we have taken all the values with H. This is 4 coins case. We are finding 5 coins. So in 4 coin case, just add H all the values at the end of the whatever we can say case. Then again I am writing H with T. Then next one H with T. T with T. Then TTHH with T. HHTH with T. HTTH with T. THTH with T. TTTH with T. HHHT with T. HTHT with T. THHT with T. Then TTHT with T. HHTT with T. T. HTTT with T. THTH with T. TTTT with T. N of S equals to 32 cases. Once we have 32 cases, we'll write event now. Event means getting at least one head. N of E. One head is, except this one, each and every value has H. So N of E, in 31 cases we have this. So probability of this event is N of E divided by N of S. 31 by 32. So these are coins problems. So we'll discuss card problems in the very next video.